all about love. Have you heard? Have you heard all about love from her?
I'm really sort of fond of clouds, of course, when we walk on clouds. I think it represents the band sonically and rhythmically. It's a lot like us. Some challenges for Mary on this record, because it's a lower register. I like the tone of her voice. I really like this, the real sensuousness.
Those were the days when we walked on clouds. Those days are over.
Well, I feel like my true nature is a violist. I like it because it's a lower, deeper instrument. It's not so focused on the flash.
Have you learned? Have you learned all about love from her? All about.
I think the band obviously knows I'm not a rock and doesn't expect me to play exactly like Rob. There's a sound to the band that was there with Rob, and I believe it's still there now.
Those days are over now. Those were the days when we walked on clouds. Those days are over now. I don't want to break your heart.
Clouds is one of the oldest things. Probably a song from the mid-90s, you know, that I did down in my basement. I don't want to tell people what the song should be about, what they think it should be about, but, you know, it's how things were, seemed easier when you were younger. They seem easier when you're younger. I mean, it's black and white.
I learned a lot more about music and a lot more about culture when I joined this band. They were like my finishing school, really. These are some smart guys.
Have you heard all about love from her? All about. Walked on clouds. Those days are over now. Those were the days when we walked on clouds. Those days are over now. Those
It's been a long process, and we work at a snail's pace, generally. We try not to get too overly excited about setting dates and deadlines and stuff.
In the big black hand.
It's just like the writing process. There's things you have to tweak and that you're not happy with, and you have to sit with them for a while. And there's other things which were like one or two takes, and boom, you're done.
Like, for example, when I'm working on guitar parts, I like to have them with me, Dennis or Steve or both, or because they will say, oh, no, try this, let's hear, you know, and I'm very open to that. I like a little bit of direction. And really, the proof is in the pudding. You know, you gotta try stuff before you know if it's good or not. So I'm very open to that process.
But there are a few songs which are really pretty special too, and that Dennis wrote the words on, and I'm singing them, I'm interpreting them. So it's really fun to become, like, to sing in his range.
You know, we all have other jobs now. You know, in that 3-year hiatus, Steve went to the college, is now the director of the theater down there. Jeff is the director of a community theater in downtown Jamestown. I'm the manager of a radio station, a community radio station. So we all got, you know, busy and did a lot of things. But we never lost the passion for playing. We started playing, you know, 5, 6, 7, or 8 times a year. And, you know, Steve finally said, we got all these songs. Let's put them together and make, you know, the new 10,000 Maniacs record.
Reggae band from New York.
Yeah, I know.
They built this in Florida.
Yeah, reggae band
from New York. Yeah. What?
Yeah, that song you guys wrote is great. No Woman, No Cry. That other one you guys wrote, The Harder They Come. No, we didn't write that. You know. So they thought we were a reggae band. Back in the old days.
Well, we thought we were a reggae band. We pretended we were.
Fountain where lemonade springs go up and down. Bluebird sings all over town. In the big rock. Rock Candy Mountain, the buzzing of the bees in the peppermint trees. Round the soda water fountain where lemonade springs, bluebird sings. In the big Rock Candy Mountain. Oh, 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 oh. It's a beautiful life. It's a beautiful life.
MTV News. You hear it first.
With singer Natalie Merchant long gone, 10,000 Maniacs are back on the road with a new singer and viola player named Mary Ramsey. The band's renaissance can be credited to, at least in part, songwriter John Lombardo, a founding member of the group who left 9 years ago before fame struck. Lombardo had been working with Ramsey as a duo, John and Mary they called themselves, and now that they've blended into the Maniacs lineup, the band is planning to start recording a new album in May, even though there is, as yet, no record deal. As for Merchant, she'll finally have a solo album out in June. That's the news for now. We'll be back with more later here on MTV.
Singer of 10,000 Maniacs, my first guest is taking the band to a whole new level. Please welcome Mary Ramsey.
Ah, gorgeous. Don't
touching me, baby. Oh, hey, so girlfriend. Gorgeous. You're gorgeous, too. Domo arigato.
Oh, arigato.
Yeah. Hey, listen, now, you've taken over the lead singer spot. Do you feel like Eve Harrington in All About Eve?
Sometimes, yes. It's kind of a weird thing, but it's been so much fun, and I get to do all the things I love to do, which is sing, write music, and play viola.
I love it. How long have you been playing the viola?
Since I was about 5 years old.
It's a sexy instrument, isn't it?
It is. It's bigger and it's lower and, you know.
Ooh. Now, a lot of times when people do the thing, their eyes are closed and they get lost into the... Do you ever, like, miss your cue because you go, like, into it too deep?
Well, what happens with me is I'll close my eyes and get into it, and sometimes I have to get right on the microphone and I'll, like, hit my mouth on the microphone, you know. So
hey,
it's kind of weird.
You guys have an album that is just fantastic. You can do some music from it. Now, you're going to go over and do a song right now, huh?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. Terrific. Now, guys, listen up. The song they're doing is called Rainy Day from the album. I have it right here. Love Among the Ruins. So please welcome 10,000 Maniacs.
Bye.
is Love Among the Ruins. You guys are fantastic. Hey, guys, when we come back, we got music from four sexy guys, 98 degrees, so stay right where you are, okay?
Family and friends said goodbye today to Rob Buck, the lead guitarist for the 10,000 Maniacs. Buck died on Tuesday and was laid to rest today in his hometown of Jamestown.
Come to me.
Family and friends of Rob Buck filled a small Jamestown chapel to pay tribute to the late artist's life and to his extraordinary talent.
And for all that intellect and artistry, Rob knew that, you know, what wisdom can you find that is greater than kindness? And Rob was a kind man.
Rob Buck died on Tuesday of liver disease. His musical career spanned 20 years. The lead guitarist was one of the founding members of the 10,000 Maniacs. Friends shared stories from the band's early days on the road to international fame.
We used to call Rob's side of the stage Rob World. And I believe Natalie once said that was, she called it the Kingdom of Rob.
Rob Buck and the Maniacs never forgot their Western New York roots. The band performed in November with the Buffalo Philharmonic Orchestra. Their last appearance here came during a rally for Hillary Rodham Clinton.
To his music that will live forever, really, for all of us, he alleviated the suffering of millions of people, even if only for a moment, when they heard him play.
Rob was still in the hospital in December of 2000. And, you know, we went down to Pittsburgh to visit him down there. I mean, he was hooked up to all kinds of machines. He was really struggling to stay alive. And that's, you know,
Gold was written quite a while ago, 5,000 years and years ago. We would work in Dennis's house, and he had a home recording studio.
A lot of different ideas going around, but I sat down and I just played part of the idea that I had, which is just that ascending thing. I had other chords to it and stuff, but I just played that over and over again, sort of. And Jeff started just stream of consciousness. He probably had 20 verses with no real form to it that he wrote. He just extemporized a good line, you know, two good lines, then some bad lines, and another couple of really good lines. So he chopped out the bad ones and jammed all the good ones together. But it was totally stream of consciousness from him. He wrote just a ton of words that day.
Well, it's an honor. It's exciting. It's been a great pleasure to co-author, work with these guys, and Mary.
A moment's like a piece of gold. Don't spend it on the wrong thing. Every moment's something you should hold. Don't spend it on the wrong thing. How can it go? Can you go? How can you go? Can you go? How can you go? Can you go? Go away. You're caught in the moment. It feels like a day. The fight's just beginning. Don't give it away. Breaths like an ocean. Your mind starts to stray. The motive's forgotten. Don't give it away. You're reeling protection, and your shield is won. Conceals imperfection by giving it up. Come on and give it all and give it up. Give it all and give it up. Give it all and give it up. Give it all and
it all or give it up. Give it all or give it up. How can it go? Can it go? How can it go? Can it go? How can it go? Can it go? Go away. Spend it on the wrong thing. Every moment something you should hold. Don't spend it on the wrong thing. How can it go? Can it go? How can it go? Can it go? How can it go? Can it go? Go away.
Was forced into classical piano lessons, and I sort of enjoyed it for a while. And then when I was, you know, 9, 10 years old, I listened to things like Creedence Clearwater Revival and all that sort of stuff from that era.
Mm-hmm. And, is playing in the Maniacs for you a retaliation against classical?
No, I play a lot of stuff that's sort of a little classical things, you know, if I want. I can do anything I want to. That's why I enjoy playing in the Maniacs. They let me do anything.
Such a fine line that
it's good. I know we can overdub those later.
There's dust coming out of my hair.
October 2015.
Yeah.
I got fairy dust.
Good evening. We are 10,000 Maniacs. This is a new song.
Cheers.
on the B flat to the B minor.
Right, so the bridge, there's only two verses and then the bridge, two things
yeah.
on the bridge.
Then the bridge.
See, I think we should probably reference this one, have Jerry.
You tell us, what is it? Come on, you're the counter.
I came in earlier, but I didn't know that one.
Try and understand the way I feel under your
trouble me, disturb me with all your cares, and your worries trouble me. On the days when you feel spent, why let your shoulders bend underneath this burden when my back is sturdy and strong? Trouble me, speak to me.
No way. Nice job.
We're all sweaty.
We're all sweating.
Sweaty specimens.
Maria, come out here. You guys ready?
Yeah.
Just start on.
I don't love you too.
today said that you don't love me. No way. I never thought I'd see the day that you don't care. Well, okay. I'd like to take a minute to say, if you don't love me,
the very beginning of the song?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.